Hey, it's Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Welcome to the Christmas Room.
Sit back, relax. You are about to watch a Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg.
I've gotten quite a few questions about what I can do with the 6K photo stream file. Is it a video file? What exactly is it? Well, I'm doing this video. It's going to be short because of space. But I'm shooting it in 6K, not in 4K. I'm shooting it on the GH5 in 6K mode. Now, in order to get that to happen, I'm using the iPad, and the iPad is showing me what I'm doing, and I can use the features here. Now, on here, I have a red record button for movie, which is the same as the red record button on the GH5, and there's a shutter button, which is also here. So I have a choice of two different buttons. Now, if I hit the actual shutter button while I have the camera set to 6K photo mode, which is on a dial on top of the camera, you just turn it to 6K and you're done. Then you set up all your settings. I'm shooting at f1.2 on the Olympus Pro 1.2 lens, 1/25th of a second shutter speed. And it's showing me here that I'm shooting in 4:36K, which means the image is going to have a lot above me and all the way down. Actually, I'm seeing beyond the front of the table. All right. Now, when I get it transformed in the computer to the 4K mode, it's going to have to obviously crop to 16:9 or whatever the proper measurements are for the file to go up on YouTube. So the only thing that's happening here that's different is it's still using my settings for my colors and my color balance, which I color balanced using a better white balance, which is my own tool, and I white balance it with that. What else? That's all I can think of. One of the questions was, I don't think I wrote that one down, so if I write it down later, I'll have to remember that I answered it. Someone told somebody, or there's some people that think that sound does not go along with the 6K mode. That's not true. We have sound going here. It's coming through the lav mic right here. But what is true is if you export it, let's say if you record it at 29 or 30p, and you export it at 30p, normally Vegas and Premiere will record the sound that goes along with it, even though you screwed up the tracks. On the 6K mode, I'm going to have to convert the transcode, all right, using Convert V, and transcode it, and I'm going to transcode it to ProRes. I'm going to do another video that's separate than this one, where I actually will come in, say hello, roll the footage, and all that kind of good stuff. And then go to the computer in the office and record my screen and show you the process of what I'm actually doing. Many people would like to see that. So this is what a video looks like with sound and everything, recording with the 6K mode. I haven't found any limitations. I've already done one that lasted 25 minutes. It handled it. The only thing is that the file was large, big, huge. It was 30 gigabytes. It was 30 terabytes. No, I'm kidding. It was 30 gigabytes for the actual 6K footage, which is being recorded in H.265 or HEVC. And it's recorded in H.265. I lost my train of thought. And then I have to transcode it because Sony Vegas and Premiere and Resolve, none of them will read the 6K file. So I'm going to probably change it over to ProRes and then from there take it into what I normally use, which is Vegas Pro 14. And there we have it. We will have a sample 6K video. So what's the advantages of shooting 6K? Because it's a 4:3 and having to get cropped down, it's going to give me a lot of latitude as to where I want to actually capture the footage. Now, if this was going to be used to capture frames, let's say for a portrait shoot or a sports shoot or an event shoot, and I want the camera running for a period of time, it will also give me a 4:3, the same as a Micro Four Thirds. It's not 3:2, which are ratios that I'm spouting out, where the Canon cameras, the Nikon cameras, they shoot in 3:2, which would be a 4:6. 4:3 would be more like a 4:5 when you print out a real print. When you go to Costco or Walgreens or wherever you go, Walmart, and you make a print. That's what 3:2 is. It's 4:6. And 4:3 is more like a 4:5, which is kind of backwards in the real world because they're giving you much more to work with for a 4:6. But when you print an 8:10 in the U.S., you're cropping out the best parts of the image. You're losing a lot of pixels. So you'd think they would shoot in 4:3, but that's not the case. So I'm just talking a little bit so you could see what a 6K video file looks like. I am not using the autofocus continuous. I'm not even sure if it'll do continuous. Oh, it has to, because I used it to do a photo session. So I'm not sure if I step back, what'll happen. I should go out of focus, right? Because I have the camera set. I guess we will both find out together. I'm just going to tap on here again. All right, I'm breaking into my own video. I went over to the camera and turned it on continuous focus, and I switched to the 225 area. And now I'm going to take one step back. This shirt should be easy to focus on. This shirt gives a lot of moire, which is why I wore it today. So this is what we've got going if we're doing the autofocus. Let's go really back. I better take the microphone spot. All right, if I'm going to stay in the focus area, I predetermined that this is the focus area. So what you can do is, if it's actually autofocusing or not, let's see what happens when I step back. It should still focus. It's not face detection. Sorry to turn my back to you. Let's see if it's still focusing on me, or if it's focusing back on the Christmas tree. I really can't tell on the iPad, to be honest with you. Now I'm back in here, and the only way I could tell what's happening is to put my finger on here. I'm going to move it over a little bit. So this way, when I move back, now this is in the 6K mode. This is why we're going through this. I'm not testing autofocus. I want to see what happens in the 6K mode. This is a lively shirt, like I said. So if it's going to follow me or not, we'll both find out together. It kind of looked like it did. The pulsing, that if you want to tell the pulsing, one of the advantages of having the Christmas room is most cameras are very, very attracted to the sparkling lights back there. They're specular, which means they're sharp points of light. And that specular part attracts camera autofocus systems. So when I get a Sony in here again, I'm going to see if the Sony's attracted to that. So you could look at the out-of-focus lights, which is why I'm shooting in f1.2. The lights will be out of focus. If the lights pulse, okay, if the lights pulse, if I come back here and the lights pulse, trying to grab onto me, you'll know that it's actually doing that vibrating action that it does to try to focus. And then when I walk back up here, the camera should try to focus back on my face. So looking at the iPad, it looks like it's in focus. Okay, we'll go back to the video and make sure I'm in focus. That's it. And all I have to do is do that. So when I say that, is just, fiddle around with it on the iPad. So that's it. A 6K YouTube video done on the Olympus GH5. Can it be done? Yeah, I'm doing it. Is there sound? Yeah, you're hearing me. So there you have it. Okay, that's the end. There's not going to be a jingle bell time today because it'll save me time transcoding. All right, Peter Gregg, Miami, Florida. Bye.
You have just watched another Peter Gregg video. Something warm, human, and wonderful happens when you watch Peter Gregg. Thank you for watching. Description of all equipment used in this video plus any notes Peter took while filming are always placed in the description box, show more box, or down arrow thingy next to the title on mobile apps. Duly noted.